Oh, it's good to be back, ladies and gentlemen. How's it going? Oh, Star Citizen, I've missed you. For those of you that are not regular viewers here on the channel, I took a couple of weeks off because my son was born, which is absolutely crazy. He's a little legend. He's like me, but smaller and much cuter. Here's a picture of him. this is me and him getting to know each other. But I'm not going to be one of those people that just talks to you about their child over and over. I'm back, and oh my goodness, we have got so much to talk about. Holy! So for those who don't know, there was CitizenCon a couple of days ago, and there was just so much information and just awesome stuff that has been... you know, released and shown and talked about. So over the next couple of videos, make sure you subscribe so you don't miss it. We're going to be talking about all these things, going into it, showing all the cool stuff, and I'm honestly just so excited to start breaking it down. I did watch it. So we had a close look at some of the planets on Pyro, which is the next system coming out in the game, which I'm honestly super excited about. We had, oh my word, we had the Spirit, the Crusader new ship, which I will talk about it a little bit later in the video. We had, and what we're covering today, the STV sports vehicle release. And I'm so excited to check it out because it looks so much fun. There's like videos and little clips that I've seen online. And my word, I cannot wait to check it out over on Daymar. So I've got my 600i here, beautiful ship. And we're going to use this to... well, I don't actually need this, really, but I'm taking it anyway because I do like the 600i. It's a good ship. So, yeah, we had looks at EVA, some of the animation and AI tools. Like, honestly, so much cool stuff to check out and sort of go over. It was really awesome to watch the segments with Chris Roberts as well, because I actually haven't really seen Chris Roberts, like... I have seen him, but like not in a like a current capacity. Everything I've seen about Chris Roberts has always been like after the fact, if you know what I mean. So that was kind of cool to actually watch that kind of up-to-date interaction with him, which was kind of cool. We had information about maps, UI, what else? I'm trying to remember everything off the top of my head. The new underground bunkers, investigation missions, multiple speeds. Oh my, there's just so much. Lawville update? There was so much. Oh my word. I'm just kind of remembering everything as I go along now. And it's just like, oh yeah. Oh yeah, I remember now. Oh my word, that is a beautiful screenshot. Holy. Taking that one. Thank you very much. Right, so first things first, let's set a waypoint to our favorite place in the verse currently, and that is Daymar, although I think Daymar's days might be numbered. I think it's Arkcorp Mining Area 4141, I think that's where you can get the thing, because there are so many good locations that we've seen in Pyro, and I'm super excited about that. Can I select... Oh my goodness, I really wish they'd shown us the new star map. That would have been cool. If you take a break from Star Citizen and come back, it just blows your mind all over again. Like, let me know in the comment section if you've, like, played Star Citizen maybe a year ago, maybe 2 years ago. You took a break and you come back, and then it, like, all over again just blows your mind. Because you do kind of get used to it in a strange way, you know? Wow, that looks cool. You see that? Whoa, that guy was zipping. What is that? Misc Razor. Damn, that was cool. Anyway, let's quantum our way to Daymar here. And check out this new sports vehicle, the STV, which I immediately bought, by the way. There was no hesitation. Like, the smaller vehicles are obviously a bit cheaper, so, like, the impulse purchase is just irresistible. I don't know about you guys, but the game seems a lot smoother with this current update. Oh, there we go. I don't know if that's a thing, maybe... I don't know. It just seems really quick and responsive today. Hmm. But yeah, so talking about a couple of the ships that I picked up. I swear I asked for this. A couple of, like, someone will have to go back and watch some of my videos and tell me if I actually did say this. I'm pretty sure I did. But they've released a ship from Crusader, or in concept, I should say, where it's kind of like the Ion, but it's kind of got space for HABs. It's got some cargo space, and there's three variants. There's the C1, which is cargo. There's the E1, which is executive, so it's got, like, passenger seats. Sorry. you have to bear with me. My brain's a bit fried at the moment. And the A1, which is like a light bomber. So I think they said size 5 missiles, which is really cool. And obviously, the difference with this Crusader ship, it's not a huge Hercules. It's kind of like that middle-sized ship between the Ion and the C2 and A2. So that, I'm just so excited about, because I swear, I love the design of Crusader ships, and the fact that they've now released, or they're planning to release, something, you know, something I can go to sleep in is awesome. So naturally, here's a picture. Hopefully I've shown you some pictures of it. It's freaking cool, all right? And I ordered all three, because of course I did. But in the comment section, do let me know which one, if any, you ordered. It was really hard to, like, resist buying all three. If I had to pick one, I probably would have picked the executive, because you guys know me, I like big classy ships. But there we go. Okay, what we got down here? Something weird is going on. What is that? Is that a C2? It is. Oh, dude, that's so cool. Are they oh no, that's an A2, is it? No, it's a C2. Nice skin on it. That's like black. What the? Landing gear. Did I knock him? I don't know. This looks cool though. Let me see if anyone's in chat. I don't think so. My idea was to take this to a sunny spot in, like, on Daymar, but I don't need to. I can just go for a drive from here, which is so cool. I think the server thinks I knocked him. Which is a bit awkward, because now if he comes out, oh no, I didn't mean to. Okay, I know you guys flame me for being the troll in this game, which breaks my heart because I love kind of messing with people. But I didn't do that deliberately, and I think that was the server's fault. Okay. Oops. I don't think that player is actually in that ship. I think he probably just logged out. I cannot. Also, that's the other thing. I cannot wait for the persistence thing to come in. I think I mention it every video now, but I'm so excited for like me to be able to have a little pocket on Daymar and then just leave my ships there. The only problem is you can't get back to your server, but that's coming in the future, you know. So. You just got hold steady on that one. Look at that. Look how cool this looks, man. Oh my word. So, I've seen... Oh yeah, there is, look. It's got little cargo space. So you can put little boxes in. That animation is sick, by the way. What's this button do? Storage. And it, like, lifts up the trunk. Or boot. Whatever you Americans would like to call it. Anything on the front here? Oh, wait a minute. Oh my word, I just realized there's freaking things here as well. Dude. Oh, that is cool. Oh my goodness, I cannot believe I only just realized this. I love the design, like these square lights and stuff. Oh, it looks so awesome. And the seats. I just honestly... The one thing I really love about this game is the amount of sheer detail in all, like, theming. So, I think I saw it in the video, but, like, you know, this is a sports vehicle designed to be rugged, replaceable, you know, be able to switch things out. And, like, that kind of detail goes into the fact that there's screws in the chair here. So, you can easily, like, unscrew one and take it out, replace it, do all that kind of fancy stuff. The other thing that I should have done... is I should have got the paint. I did buy a green paint. But oh my word, that looks good. That ship disappeared. Hmm. You know what? Let's go for a quick spin. And then I'm going to take it in my ship. Let's have a look at the interior here. Nice. Right. Okay. Engine. Boop. Oh. Look at it. It looks so good. Okay. Ooh. I love the dash. It looks so good. All right, here we go. Let's get some top speed. Oh, I left the cargo thing open. What? Woohoo! That looks great. Oh, it's so fast. Oh, no. Oh, oh no. Oh, no. Mayday. Ooh. Kind of looks cool on the bottom. It's got some great traction as well. Oh my word, this vehicle's great. Close up. Honestly, animations. This is a great little vehicle. I cannot wait to get a little video together or like a series, like literally racing this thing, because it's fast enough that you could do that. Right. Okay, let's load it onto the ship here. The other thing I kind of forgot to mention here is it's got a little gun rack, which is kind of cool. I don't think I've got a gun on me. Do I have a gun on me? No. But if you had a gun, you could put it on the side there, which is really awesome. Oh, I just love the lights. I love the design. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, my word. I just realized there's freaking things here as well. Dude. Oh, that is cool. Oh my goodness. I cannot believe I only just realized this. Look at the detail. I'm so annoyed that I only just realized that. But honestly, just looking at all the intricate details of like the suspension and the way the wheels are on. You know, like, look at the detail is so good. Did an amazing job here. I just look at it. Look at it. Like a kid in a candy store. All right. Oh, this is perfect. This is perfect. Okay, so my plan here, we do have, I think this is a bunker where I'm not really meant to be. I think, right? So my plan here is to kind of drive around and see if I can avoid gunfire. Oh, this is perfect. Hold up. Hold up. You know what? I'm just going to land. I was going to jump out. Maybe I'll do it at the end of the video. Whoa, what's that? What the? Oh, interesting. There's a bounty thing. Oh, that's kind of cool. Uh-oh. Huh. Well... I'm going to go and complete someone's bounty for them. We're going to have to do this the old-fashioned way. Get sprayed. What the? Here we go. Come on. Okay, this is not what I expected. Okay, now he's kind of damaged. That's good. Come on! Woohoo! Yes! Alright. Who else we got? Gladius? Wait, they've disappeared, haven't they? Yeah. Okay. Yeah, we got rid of the warden, and then they all disappeared. So whoever's bounty that was, you are welcome. Right. That was kind of cool. Let's land. Oh, this is honestly, this is such a cool vibe right now. Okay, open up. You see that? It keeps like bouncing. No! Oh, damn it! Wait, can I scoop it? Oh, I messed up. I messed up there. Oh, it's perfect. There you go. Look at that. Oh, this is so perfect for a thumbnail. Oh my word, that looks incredible. Hold up. Oh yeah. This looks great, man. I think it was in this direction. Oh. Actually, what I could do... Hang on. I'm levit... okay. Any sign of a big tower? I knew I should have parked closer. Hold up. Where is it? There it is. Oh, there we go. That's the camera angle. There we go. Camera hacks, man. It's brilliant. I'm pretty sure it's in this direction. I'm pretty sure it's over this ridge. So, let's try that. Oh, the sand. What a fun vehicle, though. Like, you know? Yeah, one of the cool things they're updating is actually the bunkers. I was going to talk about that in another video. But like they're doing some incredible work to make the bunkers feel a little bit more lively. Oh, man. I've completely lost it. Oh, my word. Have you ever seen a better ramp? Look at that. It was made for this moment. Let's even get some speed. No, I don't really have much speed. No. Oh, no. Woohoo. Nice. Hey. Satisfying. Very satisfying. Where is the bunker, man? I feel like I'm really close. Right, okay, so... maybe down this hill? Maybe? Come on. It would give me so much pleasure to see that little outpost. I'll put lights on. Lights off. Okay. Are we any closer now? It's hard to know because this map isn't really designed for what we're doing here. We're so close. I just wish I knew a direction to go in. You know? This is going to be pretty epic though. Are you ready? This is actually going to be sick. Da-da-da-da! The perfect ramp! Here we go! Whoa! Hit the rock! Nice! Hey, so much fun. Let's check the star map. I'm so annoyed I'm lost. Is there a way I can just like... I feel like the only way I'm gonna find this place is if I go back to my ship. But we were 6,000 meters away, so... Yeah, let's find out how close we were. Oh my goodness, this is actually quite exhilarating. Driving through the rocks here, at high speed. Da-da-da! Oh, that's such cool. Woo! Can't see. Oh, rocks! Oh! Oh dear. Oh, that's bad. Oof. Close one. Okay, this is honestly so stressful for me right now because I want to know if I was at least heading in the right direction. If I spent like 20 minutes heading in the wrong direction, I'm going to be a little upset with myself. But also, if I was really close and I just turned around, I'm going to be even maybe more upset. So, turn everything on. Quantum. It was in that direction. How far away is it though? No, you're joking. 5,000? What? So I literally must have gone past it. How? Because I was about 6,000 meters away and I was literally right next to it. That's so frustrating. What? I'm mortified. I was so close to it. Oh. Oh my word. Oh. I think. Remember when I turned around, I was like, oh, it might be in this big divot. Da-da-da-da! The perfect ramp! Here we go! I'm pretty sure that's where it was. Oh, so annoying. Alright, whatever. Let's park up here. So I was literally right next to it, and then I decided to turn around. That's kind of hilarious. Alright, okay, take two. Yeah, I must have literally... I'm pretty sure I got... Well, I'll have to watch it back. I bet you see it in the edit as well. Which makes it even more annoying. But never mind. So... It was in the next ridge. Dude, this is really hard when you're in the frickin' car. Wait a minute, I think I found it! So the reason why this is tricky is the thing doesn't stick out of the ground, so there's no... God's sake. There's no, like, you know, when you're low to the ground in this little vehicle, there's nothing really giving it away. It's kind of hidden, which I guess is kind of the point. But I'm pretty sure it's over this ridge. Here we are! Nope. What a troll. Okay, now I'm completely, like, confused and annoyed. Where the hell is this thing? And why am I upside down again? I'm getting so annoyed. Okay, right. Oh, wait. I see a turret. Okay, good. So it's the next ridge. All right, we found it eventually. Oh, my word. I'm not even kidding. That was like an hour's worth of searching. Woohoo! Hey, bro! This is kind of cool. Come on, then. Give me your best shot. Oh, that looks so awesome. He's not really firing, though. There's literally a turret right there. Ah, that was kind of the point. You were meant to try and shoot me while I was driving around. No? We're not doing that? Just chill vibes? Hmm. Alright, well. I can't get mad if you're just deciding not to shoot me, I suppose. The problem is, guys, I don't have a weapon, so going down here is a little bit dumb. Right, loot. Any loot? Mm-hmm. Hello. Loot. And a gun. Nice. And a med gun. Oh, my word. Lucky day. Haha. This has actually been a really good loot run. Alright, I think I'm good. Whoa! Hang on, what did I pick up? That looks good. And, what is this? Oh, it's an arrowhead. Nice! Nice scope as well. Look at that. Well, that was definitely worth going in just to grab some loot. That's the coolest scope I think I've ever seen. And I'm wondering here if it will let me... look, there we go. That looks rad. That's so cool. Nice. All right. Sweet. Successful. I actually made out alive. Guys, if you've enjoyed this video, definitely drop it a thumbs up. Plenty to talk about. I haven't really talked about too much in this video today, but there is more to talk about. So, yeah, stay tuned for that. And I'll catch you later. Bye-bye.